So I'm going to sell out for the wrong people real quick. This new Corsair keyboard is really nice and all this, and I unboxed it on stream yesterday. It feels so cool. It's so weird using the rapid fire switches, though, man. Like, just getting into game now, even, I was like, okay, now it feels like I'm not pressing enough, but now I'm pressing too much, and this is going to take some getting used to. So I bring this up not as an ad, but as a simple statement of if things are going a little bit haywire in stream, my apologies, as I got to get used to using the new keyboard all over again. But it is a best of five here for the Ting Open, spawning the bottom right side of the map. Playing for my insanity, it's going to be the blue Protoss BT Drogo. It will henceforth be known as Drogo for the rest of the cast.
Okay. In the bottom left as the red Protoss, he is Welmu.
We should have made this map with our Templar and Tal Darim mod.
Well, someone didn't tell me to do that.
Oh, I don't think we should have actually done it. I was just making a small comment. For those who haven't been following, the Civil War has been a tournament we've been hosting with Protoss versus Protoss only. It's actually been a lot of fun, and we've had some really great matches, but most importantly, it comes with in-game skins, which has made it quite a bit more exciting to watch. Drogo currently represents the Templar, and also has a t-shirt for sale available under the stream if you guys haven't seen it. The really cool thing about that t-shirt is 50% of the proceeds will go to the player, as if they were the one making the deals at Teespring. So make sure to check out that t-shirt. But anyways, the point of bringing this up isn't to sell out for a shirt. It is to just remind you, as we've seen Drogo's PvP, and it looks good. And more importantly, it looks good in best of fives. Had the games we cast with him prior to today been best of threes, he would have actually lost a lot of them, and they wouldn't have even had a chance to play. But we saw really epic comebacks, we saw really great holds, and he's someone who very quickly identifies the style of his opponent, which I think is the most important factor in PvP.
Yep. I think he won twice from a comeback and then lost once from a comeback.
They finally got knocked out. Yeah. Welmu, I could give this guy credits all day, but the thing is he just hasn't had good results recently. So I really am a little bit indecisive between the two, because Welmu's PvP was once at a time like the godliest of gods. Drogo's looking really good now. I would actually have to coin flip to guess who I would think would win the series. But very different openers already, by the way. We got the Stalker following this up, whereas the Stalkers are made initially for Drogo.
Right, right. Two different openers. Well, two different unit openers, I should say. Because actually, the openers themselves weren't that different. And they both will probably be looking for a Nexus eventually, but with the Adepts there, maybe Welmu was going to snipe Drogo's Nexus attempt.
Okay, well, this is really important. Drogo's Adepts timed out like this, by the way. I was going to mention, it's the difference of kills you can get in that mineral line, and of course this Adept's going to give it 3. The Mothership Core looks like she got about 3 and then died, didn't recall. Ooh.
That's pretty
a little
bad.
Bit more costly.
That is pretty bad. The Adept not getting 2, I thought was... Oh, well now these Mothership Core can get 2.
Maybe, I don't know, the Stalkers might stay at home. So, real quick, well, yeah, they did. Real quick point here, there's a couple of different styles to play PvP. The more Korean style that we're seeing out of Drogo more recently has been like this sort of charge-led zealot aggressive timing. Generally speaking, though, a lot of the Europeans have been playing the more the Blink Stalker Disruptor attack style, and it's beaten Drogo every time we've seen it. So, I'm not sure if Drogo's going to open directly into Stalkers and Disruptors and say, okay, I've learned my lesson by now through 100 million PvPs, this is the best way to play against certain people. But he may also try and blitz. This Robo is certainly no indication yet that that's the direction it's going, because a Warp Prism could be just as useful as an Immortal, depending on how you use it.
Sure, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's worked, and sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, I should say. So it is about finding out what works against your opponent.
This
you have 5 games to try and figure it out.
Was phenomenal payback damage, by the way. 2 Adepts for a couple of probes, but more importantly, 2 Sentries.
Yeah, that is really nice. So that brings up a total of probes killed to 7 for Drogo, but the sentries were a lot of gas to have to replace, and Wilma would like to replace them, so there he goes using it now. Robotics Bay on the way, so we're going to have Drogo with Disruptor drops. He tried this once before on Star Station, because he brought that map back for the Civil War, and it didn't go so hot. he was also Blink Stalker attack around the same time he was trying to use Disruptor, and if things had gone like perfectly, he might have been able to hold, but it really was a hard hold when you go for like tech super fast like this. I don't think it's going to be the same like thing that happens here. It is Ruins of Endion, and Wellmu's not really looking to pressure at all. And, you know, even if he did use Blink Stalkers, there's not really that abusive cliff like there was on Star Station. I think there's also like a sentry on the force field because there was a war prism. Point is, it's not going to happen. So Drogo should have free reign to just drop the disruptor. And hopefully the goal is to never let it die. If it doesn't die, you have decent macro back at home, then good for you.
I really like that he did this, by the way, the disruptor play. As much as I really did enjoy watching his archons and charge lots, it did feel a bit silly watching him get beat down so easily by a lot of the guys who were going straight to disruptors. But okay, this first one, we'll see how much damage you can get. I mean, you get to the Mineral Lion, maybe they're paying attention, maybe they're not. I think the best case for him would actually be if the Stalkers and the Sentries got pulled and get to pick those off. PvP, I feel, so often becomes a lot more about the army than the probes when it comes to fights and accumulating losses. Good pull out of Wellmu, though, really not underreacting and paying very good attention.
Yeah. I mean, this could have been Adept Warpins, but you still would want to pull the probes against that. Actually, pulling the probes can sometimes be the wrong move, depending on how close the disruptor is, but it wasn't that close. Now there's two, so that army is suddenly going to be very careful about how it tries to engage and stop the disruptors from getting shots, because the Mothership Core can only be so helpful. I like the pylons, and it almost worked out. It was just a little bit not timed well.
Nope,
they might still
work
out.
It's still going to get it. One disruptor goes down, the other one's just going to get caught in the middle of this. That was actually, it's funny. This has not been a dynamic game where it's army versus army, but this has been incredibly expensive trades back and forth. The sentries early on, the disruptors now. Drogo just got a TT because I think he knows how bad that was for him. Luckily, with the rocks being broken down on the other side of the map and potentially being broken down on his, he could probably buy time to try and make that up. But I'm going to figure with Caster A from Take TV.
Well, Blink is on the way for Drogo now. We do not have it yet for Wellmu, who did go for the Phoenix, the Stargate, I guess, instead of that Blink. So that's an interesting choice. I mean, the Phoenix can lift the disruptor as it's going to disrupt this disruptor, but if Drogo figures out what's happening, I don't think he has to go for disruptor. I mean, it seems kind of off because that's what he opened up with, but he could try and actually just morph in Archons over disruptors and try and take a fight.
Well, I like the idea of the Phoenix, especially in this position. You already know you killed two of the disruptors. You know that he's probably going to want to play a little bit more heavy with the Warp Prisms. Consistent scouting out of both players as well with these hallucinations to see what exactly is going on. Drogo forced to just kind of play catch up on the ground. I mean, he's behind in upgrades. He's now getting his resonating glaives. And of course, his plans were all just laid to ruin with that attack. I mean, that really was about the worst that could have been for him, unfortunately.
Yeah, it was. I guess he actually didn't have to morph Archons at all. It's going to be a bit of a tricky fight, I think. And I think it's going to be trickier for Wellmu when the push actually comes to use the Phoenix absolutely correctly. Because if there are any High Templars, they could also just feed back the Phoenix, you know, they'll still great at maybe taking out the War Prism, but they would no longer be able to lift the Disruptors. And what is there much else besides those?
Did I miss the Stimpak sound, or is Twitchler's bugged again?
Oh, I forgot to put it up, so I have no idea.
Alright, well, Zelane89, thank you for the 4-month resub. Maybe I just forgot about it, or missed it because it's bright and early. That's what I would attribute it to. Man, I'm tired. Sorry, and I could definitely tell that through the observing, and you guys probably can too. Real quick note, though, on the actual unit count. Again, Drogo were expecting to be behind. You know, he lost his disruptors early on. But funny enough, with three disruptors on the ground, a couple of immortals, he's not in too terrible of a spot. But as long as his phoenixes are a threat, they're going to constantly be able to come in the back line and deny, basically remove the disruptors from the fight. They might not be able to dive in and kill, but as long as they're not able to shoot their shots off, that's what's going to matter most. So, Drogo's getting this point now where he's going to have an abnormally large amount of disruptors. It's actually going to be very difficult for the Phoenixes to lift them all up. I really like the cannons coming down. Not only is it just kind of that static defense, but also some detection should there be DTs, which, let's be honest, their shenanigans appear more in this matchup than they should.
Yeah. I think that Drogo, I mean, he saw the Stargate, but I'm not sure he realized that there was actually going to be Phoenix made. Like, he saw one Phoenix made when he scouted it first. No, he seems to be, like, Wellmu hasn't shown his Phoenixes yet, so he might be trying to hide them. And then, Like, I don't actually know if Drogo realized it was happening. I mean, now they're coming. Okay, there they are. So disruptors can be picked up now. This is where a couple of either Archons actually hit the Phoenixes, hopefully when they're all clumped up, or High Templars to feedback them
would be
very useful. But he would only have, like, one feedback for, like, I think, like, two High Templar at most with the gas he has now. So it wouldn't even be worth warping in now.
Drogo is... He was trying to put two cannons in instead of just the one. Really worried about having to look on his back line for this. I mean, I like it, too. Playing ultra safe. There's several cannons at these bases. The depths have been left up here as well. He knows the warp prism's nearby. Meanwhile, this army tentative to fight. And, you know, the thing about these Phoenix... We've talked about them before, like whether they can swoop in and pick these up or not. There's now so many disruptors, that might not be an option. There's 8 Phoenix of the 9 disruptors, but even then, having all 9 units crowd controlled simultaneously is going to be a task in and of itself. Let's take Overcharge, by the way, going to hold this. Nice SimCity, accidentally or on purpose with that cannon, keeps the Zealots from going anywhere further. That disruptor also going to hold this line not too badly. Pushes through the front lines, though, when he realizes Drogo was pulling army out of position.
Yeah. Drogo did just warp in some Archons, so really just that anti-air. The Phoenixes could, like, in a ideal world, could just pick up all of those, but the cannons and maybe a couple Fortune Overcharges might tear them down, too. It's actually really hard to call, and I'm not sure how this fight is going to look. It did end up being Charge Lot Immortal Archon Phoenix versus Blinkstalker Immortal Disruptor.
I love
a Void Ray on the way.
This for the Warp Prism, I guarantee you more than anything else, and I love that choice. You know, there's plenty of cannons coming up for that static defense, but that's going to be best suited for just shooting down this Phoenix. So I don't know how much Drogo's willing to push forward, but he is getting some decent shots with these disruptors. However, that was like 11 shots before he hit anything, so hard to say that this is going to be super cost-effective to use these in this manner. But looks like that fight's going to get forced. Mumbo dives in. He's looking for those Graviton beams. Picks up some of the disruptors. Doesn't get all of them, though, and some still go off on the Immortals. A lot of them taking out the health right away. The cannon's doing work on these Archons on the backside. Drogo is winning this fight very, very well, despite being down in upgrades. 3 weapons upgrades, 1 armor for Wellmu, 2 weapons for Drogo.
Yeah.
But while this goes on, looks like DTs and Zealots started to do work as well, and an entire natural base was gutted raw. Oh, does he not have detection?
No. Oh, no, he doesn't have observers, Zombie Grub.
He's about to get some, though, and, like, the damage has already been done in his natural. That's too bad. Oh, this is powering the observer. That was actually...
No,
there's another one. Good. There's also another Robo, so either way, there's going to be at least one observer out. So, killing probes... I don't think is that big of a deal, because Drogo's still at 63. He started remaking them, I think, pretty quickly.
Yeah, 4 bases as well.
And he still took the much better fight, and a lot of Wellmu's supply is in what could be potentially useless Phoenixes, but those Phoenixes actually did a really good job.
Yeah, they lift up a lot of the disruptors. Those shots don't go off. That forces Drogo off this a little bit, but the depths in the front lines versus the Immortals, we got the slow warping coming out of Wellmu, perhaps not realizing this. That's so many cells denied as the pylon gets shut down.
Yeah, we had a couple of Hussein Archons as well in the front. I don't know if that was
just
all
the cool moves.
Sentries, or you just
cancel.
Some other units. No cancel on Wellmu. I mean, I'm surprised he even tried to take that base. Like, the last indication of a fight did not look very good for him.
You know,
to think that the next one was going to go so much better was just,
Look at Wellmu's upgrades. Like, he's really running away with this. Drogo's just now finishing up +3, but Wellmu had, like, 3, 2, and 1, something you don't often see. Drogo's also transitioning into air behind this, which I find really interesting. Something to do when he's behind in the Phoenix count. I mean, there really isn't a lot of anti-air in this army still. Those are hallucinated. Those are not real Archons. A couple of Stalkers. Maybe cannons come down. North side, we got some Warpins coming in, but Drogo's going to respond with the Depths. Look, he should be okay for now. DT being the scariest thing here, but of course that cannon provides detection.
Yeah, this should be actually pretty easy. I'm a little surprised Drogo doesn't push in to win, but he is transitioning, and if he lost the army, if things actually did go very poorly for the fight, I guess he wouldn't want to be caught with his pants down, like only with 3 Tempests and, you know, not much else in the ground. Because they're not really accruing that much of a bank yet. But he has been taking very good fights, despite what is, you know, some pretty good Phoenix liftoffs.
I'm still impressed just seeing the recovery from the early War Prism loss. Like, maybe that's on Wellmu for not capitalizing and pushing, but also somewhat limited by those said Phoenix. You know, when that's your composition, you don't have a big pushing force. But canceling the Adept Transfer, wants to play behind the SimCity. All the disruptors fire off on everything, realizing he was going to have them picked up. Nicely done as he takes out all the ground army of Wellmu. Only really an Archon and an Immortal remains. He's going to warp in some more Zealots on the back line, but there's so many Adepts here, Zombie Up. There's just no way this is going to work out. Cannons and Stalkers alike. GG gets called, and Drogo will take game number one. That was a damn good game out of Drogo, I must say.
It was a good game out of Drogo. I'm actually a little confused about Welmu. Not that his idea wasn't good. We've talked about Phoenixes and their dynamic before, but it just... I don't know how he would have done it better, or how Drogo...
Well,
like, what made Drogo so amazing that he just dealt with that super easy?
No, I just think it was the Manner of Disruptors versus Charizard Archons. I understand and respect the Korean style of playing that. That's what a lot of the Koreans are going for, but... Oh... Welmu needs a small break. We're going to go to ads, guys. We'll talk more about this afterwards. But the TLDR is like, this strategy, we saw the same story with Drogo, right? In Civil War. Drogo came out with Welmu's strategy, kept losing to Disruptors, finally adapted to Disruptors himself, and then started winning. So I really think it has a lot to do with unit composition, as cool as the Phoenixes are. But either way, like we said, small break while Welmu hopefully feels better. See you guys in a minute. Well, 2 minutes. All right, folks, welcome back. Game number 2 in this best of 5 at the Ting Open. If you haven't already, make sure to check out bttv.ting.com and claim the $25 in credit. A lot of people don't know this, but you can use this in their store. So even if you don't plan to sign up and use Ting services, you can still get $25 in discount on a new phone or anything available through their store. This tournament, of course, wouldn't be possible without them. In the top left side, as I hit the wrong button there for some strange reason, it's going to be the red Protoss, My Insanity's Drogo, currently up 1-0.
In the bottom right, as the blue Protoss, he is Welmu.
Play for NC Sports. Mm-hmm. Ah, I figured it out. This keyboard. Okay, first off, love Corsair gear. I'm not even going to be talking negative on it. K70, wonderful piece of equipment. But I'm now realizing how delicate the rapid-fire switches are, because not only do they respond faster when you click, I guess they're also a little bit more clickable. So as my finger would normally hover over the 2 key, for example, and not barely touch it and cause no interaction in the past, now it's putting on player vision.
Ah, that's a little unfortunate.
I just gotta stop. Bad habits get formed. It's like me tapping. I don't know why I do this. I've got a really bad habit of tapping the caps lock key when I'm doing things. No idea why, I just do. So for example, if you guys ever have talked to me on Skype, you probably at some point see me randomly message you in all caps, and that's because when I'm sitting here idle, I will just tap the caps lock key. I have no idea why, I just do.
That is weird. But I guess we all have those things. Okay, so last game, it talked about it a little bit after the game. Oh, there's actually Stargate, it's going to be scouted. That's interesting. But the Phoenixes, I guess, were something that Drogo actually didn't experiment with.
It didn't get scouted.
Okay, well, it should have been. Drogo, come on.
I mean, the probe
get back there.
The probe can usually stay for a significant amount of time, but this is...
Uh-oh.
Does Welmu know? Like, he's got to know from the probe pathing that there's no way that saw that. Like, I thought that looked a little bit fishy, so I checked the vision, and he didn't even come close to seeing that.
He was in the mineral line, and that might be an assumption, but...
He didn't see anything, man.
That's so that's supposed to happen. Well, I don't think it's going to be game over, but it's something that's very, very scary, because if Drogo thinks like, wow, I'm doing a lot of damage, let me just send these stalkers out, like, no problem, then maybe it does something. The Mothership, of course, should always be at home this early. Well, actually, I think in these positions, it's always going to stay at home. Like, Ruins Veniana was close by air, so they kind of both sent Mothership, of course, over, but...
All right, these Adepts are going to get in, by the way, and get a couple of probe kills, but more importantly, see that Stargate, and I think there were suspicions for it. He didn't scout it directly, but 4 kills for probes, not too bad. Probably get about 6 or 7, maybe, but knowing that the Oracle's actually coming is a pretty big deal. Leaving the Stalkers at home, not moving out with them to follow up, and of course, that Mothership Core having the Overcharge ready. Drogo should not take much, if any, damage from this.
Yeah, now should take no damage, and... I mean, really just starts off with a nice lead, assuming that he doesn't. With 4 units, actually, in a Mothership Core, this is going to be almost impossible for the Oracle to do any damage. But maybe the next time. And Welmu didn't delay his Nexus very much at all for this. In fact, still got like a bit faster of a Nexus, despite getting that Stargate earlier. And, I mean, now he just to catch up on probes, which, I mean, 7 is a lot in a mirror matchup.
Yeah, I absolutely agree. What do you think, though? So we talked a little bit about this after the game. The disruptor factor versus no disruptor factor. Do you think Welmu tries to play without them again, or do you think he learns his lesson after game 1?
I really don't know. I mean, I think I was of the opinion, I think you agreed, and I think you just did it just now, that when it comes down to like late game, disruptors always seem to win out. So I don't know why people even attempt it, except to try and hit some type of really rush, like hard attack, which Wilmo didn't really do. I mean, that game was not exactly passive, but like not super like fight up to four bases. So I would say no, because especially because I can't think of a way that Wilmo does it better. Not a pro Protoss, so, though. Maybe, like, miss a timing or something.
My only thoughts for Wilmo are actually what Drago ended up doing, where we saw him start transitioning to Tempest at the very end of the game. And if you don't have your own disruptors, I can kind of see Sky Toss, in that regard, working in your favor. At least you'll be able to force fights or stop them from getting free hits. But, well, the Golden Armada is certainly the dream, and I think endgame PvP, like, the ultimate endgame PvP is going to be Carriers, Tempest, and Motherships together. That's a very difficult thing to pull off.
That is an interesting point. I definitely could see, especially if Wilmo, because Wilmo, I believe, was the one who engaged. I mean, eventually Drago would have engaged, but he wasn't the one to first do it. He probably could have gone to Tempest and start picking disruptors off. And I think that's... It really seems like the only way I could figure that working, unless Wilmo just, like, you know, got crisper timings, or maybe actually went and picked up the disruptors that were shooting. Because maybe that was the biggest problem, was that he picked up disruptors
A little too...
Yeah, well, I mean, he picked him up immediately, right? Like, he figured I could get all the disruptors and he would miss one or two. And instead of waiting for them to shoot their shots and then picking them up, like, I don't know.
Oh, but... I see what you mean. Like, trying to get the cancel rather than the deny.
Yeah, exactly. But I really don't know.
I think that's a little too particular. I mean, I agree. Like, obviously, in a perfect world, that's what you want to do. I think it might just be a little too particular and difficult to pull off in this sort of setting. I think if you got the pressure of your tournament life and it's the DreamHack Finals, then yeah, I can see you trying to pull something like that off.
Well, those are all reasons why I think that Wilmo won't be going for the same thing. But he has that Stargate, and it was something where I think he definitely wanted to be more of a surprise as well. But I guess I do question, like, how would it ever be a surprise, like, enough of a surprise, right? Like, if they stop building disruptors, I guess at 5, then you have enough phoenixes for sure, and that's probably the ideal situation. But I mean, most late game Protosses PvP seems like more disruptor better until about like 10, which I think Drago had about 8, right? So,
well, that's actually another thing I find rather interesting about the disruptor counts from what we've seen in the massive amount of PvPs we've been covering. Whereas in the past, Colossus had a really hard fall-off point where it's like, if you've got more than 6 Colossus, you're probably doing it wrong. Disruptors don't seem to have that same hard cap. Like, they're like any other unit. You can have too many Immortals because then you leave yourself vulnerable to anti-air, same with Disruptors. But it feels like you really just don't. When it's ground versus ground only and there's no counters, like, you can have infinite Disruptors and have the best time in the world.
Yeah, that's kind of the thing I'm feeling I'm getting as well. But we have a attack prepped from Drago this time, and Wilmo, I think, has enough to defend it. Like, Photon Overcharges, Force Fields.
Yeah, I love the Stasis Traps around this, too. I think that's a great addition.
Yeah. And I'm actually not quite sure. Okay, I was going to say, if Drago...
Oh, that pylon! He's warping in from the wrong pylon! Oh, the pylon that's touching the Nexus should have been the one warping in from.
That sucks. It's going to get a few more kills for those Adepts, and... Drago has started off this game with a probe lead, now, you know, continues to have one, and he has been winning the income advantage.
His upgrades are significantly behind, though. Like, one was coming up in +2 shortly, and that's a pretty big deal.
Yeah. It happened last game, but the fact that disruptors don't really need upgrades really just, you know, took care of that, no problem. And I'm not... It is going to be Blink once again from Drago, for sure. He has that already. But, you know, he's going to this Robo. Okay, makes sense. Going for Disruptors. Wilmo is getting Blink, but not so far Robotics Bay. So
yeah,
he's just going to go
no
Blink Immortals.
I mean, if you want just Blink Stalkers, it's good to have. You want that tool, you want the mechanic, you need to be able to dance. But this is certainly an odd thing to see.
Okay, I'm gonna blink back maybe a little bit faster.
Okay, yep, this is a little bit awkward. Maybe whatever.
Well, you know, Wilmo's not exactly in a problematic spot yet, because he does have this very, very high immortal count. Like, if he pushed into Drago right now, he might win, because he has 6 immortals to 1. But if he waits too long and Drago has 1 and then 3 and then 5 disruptors, I mean, like, eventually one of the two of them are gonna get shots, and, you know, they'll probably win out the war. And Wenlo's not pushing. He's just defending, so...
I love this very subtle harass that's been going on, too. Like, no one's really dedicating too much, like, you know, disruptors in a warp prism or anything, but the Adepts on the side, the Zealots on the north, just nobody playing entirely passive, despite this being a passive game. But this is big problems. I don't know that Druggos recognize how far behind his upgrades are. As you mentioned before, disruptors can help bridge that gap, because while as good as plus three is on Stalkers, the disruptor's always going to be better. But getting those hits is a hard task to ask for.
I think Drogo should probably just give up the fourth, actually. I didn't know if Wimbo was going to attack, but he does, and this is still a point where he has a lot more mortals than Drogo has, like, you know, possibilities of getting disruptor shots, although that one is pretty good. and I think giving up the fourth whistle, you can cancel it, is not that much of a problem, really.
Oh,
now
gosh.
There's a disruptor shot.
Yeah. I feel like he's getting a lot of these shots, too, not even by luck. Like, Wimbo's not even trying to dodge. Like, he's just kind of taking
the
hit.
Oh, that was such a risky blink forward. I mean, there's still the immortals are still alive, even if they are low.
Yeah, he wants to pounce, though. Force is going down. He's trying to give chase. The Shepard shot wasted, unfortunately. For Drogo, this was a weird fight to try and take, because this was a base. This was your fourth. This is where you're trying to get a lead in the game, but you're already kind of ahead through those probe count. Just trying to have better reasoning for it. It's a tough location to hold, but defensively with disruptors, he should be able to.
Oh, these disruptors might die to those CTs. Once again, caught without an observer.
Ooh.
Huh. That's gonna be interesting. And there's not really a way for him to notice that in, like, the big army. Although maybe he figures this around the time. Oh, you know what? I think his warp prism might have scouted it. That's what happened. So he knows, and now he's getting an observer.
Oh, but that blink forward puts blink on cooldown to line the disruptors to fire off and kill some stalkers. This is one of the problems with your blinking. You gotta be careful with that cooldown. Of course, the Observer's on the way. It just got made. It's not on the front lines just yet. He's got to be careful with this.
Yeah, very careful. Temple Archers have finished up, so we can start morphing in those Archons to also get... I mean, they might hit the army, but also just take a lot of damage themselves.
So he's going in from behind. Interesting choice. Splitting his army into two. Disruptor's going to be hitting on those front lines. Stalker's already blinked once, but the cooldown should be coming off soon. Oh my god, a chunk of the Immortals falls on that left side. More Disruptor shots going to go down. Army getting destroyed. Despite having better upgrades, Wenlo is falling apart. And this, well, as good as the DTs are, Zombie, I mean, it's a couple of kills here and there versus the whole army getting devastated.
Yeah, those DTs were very annoying, though. Like, I think without those DTs, Drogo has maybe, like, 10, 20 or more army supply. Especially with those last snipes. I know, he definitely made one when he noticed the Dark Shrine.
Oh, it's with the mothership. It's like inside the mothership. Boy, that looks so weird.
Whoa. Okay, well now he brings it forward.
Also, today I learned the mothership coin and the observer is the same movement speed, I guess. 2.62 and 2.62. Useless fast with Fear Dragon, guys.
Well, Wenlo has actually been losing this... fight this war for actually since the get-go. I think a cancel on the fourth was not enough, and then he lost. It wasn't just losing an army, he was losing out in the technology war.
Yeah, I mean, it's so almost frustrating to watch a player as good as Wenlo, because I love Wenlo. You just have to understand, like, between the two of them, I would cheer for Wenlo every time. I like Drogo. I'm doing an event with Drogo, so there's no disrespect here, but just Wenlo's got this history of really great PvP, so it's so strange to watch him what almost feels like fall apart right now. Two games back-to-back, none of his own disruptors. I'm not sure if he just doesn't feel confident in the use or what the deal is, but he's taking terrible fights because he's just not fighting with all the tools he needs. He's bringing a knife to a gunfight, a stalker to a disruptor fight.
It is very just like, maybe Wenlo is like that guy that has the odd PvP, you know? There's always that one person that has an odd mirror matchup, or regular matchup, and mirror matchup. But... you know, we've cast 15 at least PvPs in the Ord Civil War, and granted that's with almost the same five people, not all six, but like none of these fights have looked like those. So Wenlo's just playing really odd.
And we've cast more than 15. It's been like 25 or something, because there's a lot of East matches in those best of fives. But all right, we're in base trade territory, baby, and this is where I actually give Wenlo a bit of an edge. He's got better upgrades, so kill buildings stronger and faster. Disruptors might be better at killing the army, but they're not better at killing buildings.
That's absolutely true. Drogo does have a fourth base that Wenlo still has to clean up, but Wenlo took a hidden base.
Even with the hidden base coming into play, I mean, Wenlo's probably... Oh, focus that forge, man. Don't let him finish those plus two upgrades. That's actually going to be pretty huge. I can't believe he's letting him do this.
He really wanted the Robos?
Ah, Wenlo. Oh,
wow.
He's trying to depower everything, but he should depower the forge.
Jesus.
Plus two actually gets
one
the finish.
Second. 1 second too late. Well.
Okay, so, by the way, the difference of plus 3 and plus 1 is a pretty big deal. The difference of plus 3 and plus 2, not such a big deal. But, oh, you know why he focused on the robo? He was hoping there wouldn't be any more observers.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, yeah. There are. DTs get dealt with. And this is looking pretty grim for Womble. Even with this hidden base being what it is, Drogo's pretty well fortified in. That's a lot of cannons. He's going to pre-pull some probes, too. Start running across the map. Get ready to set down another Nexus, another set of assimilators. You name it.
Right.
Oh, and Womble's doing the same.
I think Drogo should be scouting at least one of those probes, trying to figure out where Wenwu's potential hidden base is, because it is a base trade, and smart base trades will go ahead and take that hidden base, but he's not, so it might be a bit of a runaround to try and find Wenwu's hidden nexus, because, you know, in 30 seconds, he's going to be like, where was that revealed alert?
Yeah, it should have been, yeah, your opponent's being revealed, et cetera, but he's just going to build a nexus in Womu's natural because he can. Recalls back home,
recall.
By the way. Oh, and this is something where Disruptor's going to make quick work of Womu's army. Blinks on cooldown. Whether Drogo recognizes that or not, I don't know.
Unfortunately, is SimCity working against him? He's actually going to go ahead and kill those gateways. Can't really use him anyway, so why not?
He's probably the buildings as he chases the army back. That's kind of funny.
Yeah.
DT is coming to play. Once again, there's no detection, really. No cannons, either.
This could still, in a very, very wonky world, go to Wenwu, but, like, he has such a time, a fun time ahead of him, actually killing every single building of Drogo, because he's not going to take on the army. Even if it splits up half and half, I don't think he can take on.
He's, like, slowly collapsing on it from both sides, though, that pincer.
Yeah.
I mean, I agree, like, there's this one perfect world where Wenwu somehow catches Drogo off guard, but it doesn't look like it's going to be here and now. Really good fight gets taken for Drogo.
One of the Observer gets his own Observer killed, and now Drogo could get a Dark Shrine and have probably a good time. So Wenwu is officially lost at this point.
Yeah, and most importantly beyond that is just the fact that there won't be any Observer snipes for Drogo anymore, so he won't have to worry about lacking detection.
No, he won't. With three Observers, it was very unlikely that Wenwu was going to kill every single one with only one of his Observers, but... he's got to know it's game, but he still has those DTs, I suppose. He's hoping that they can actually run around alongside the Blinkstalkers. But eventually Drogo would, you know, mix up his observers, actually put one in one place and one on his army.
He just killed the DTs, so 6-8 Stalkers, all that remains for Wenwu. He's trying to mine in the upper right, and I guess he has mining going for him. Drogo does not, but irrelevant, I feel, to the situation.
Oh, yeah, it is. GG.
All right, congratulations to Drogo, who will take a 2-0 lead. Wenwu's got one more game to try and bring this back. But it is specifically PvP. We have been seeing continual comebacks from, like, 0-2s. So, I'm not sure. This could just as easily be 3-0. We'll find out which direction this goes shortly. Do stick with us, though, guys. We'll be back in a moment with game number 3. All right, folks, we are getting into game. And we're just going to skip the intro. Spawning here in the upper left side of Arena, we've got the red Protoss. He's currently dominating 2-0. And one game away from locking this down, it's Mind Sanity's Drogo.
In the bottom left, as the blue Protoss, he is Wenwu.
Alright, so just a quick heads up, guys. This first series, of course, happening in Europe, reminder to everybody as... I was messaging Solar in between games, but he needed that break as he misunderstood what was going on. He'll be playing next against Sort of, and that'll be happening on North America.
Mm-hmm. Middle ground. Makes sense.
Yeah. The wildcard qualifiers really were meant, like, in my perfect world, would have one player from each region in the group. Like, one person qualifies here and there, but unfortunately, we saw very little to no North American participation and very little to no Korean participation. So.
Yeah.
It just ended up being what it was.
Yeah. I have to be right back for 2 minutes, so...
Okay. Good luck, have fun. Double gateways came down for both, though. I really like the... I guess how common this opener has become. It's not so much that you necessarily are always going to go for Adepts yourself. We saw in game number 1, for example, we saw the difference of Stalkers first versus Adepts first. But the idea is, especially on a map like Arena, you've got a lot more potential to get some damage done and actually get into your opponent's mineral line, maybe snipe off 4 or 5 drones, have a grand old time. For Wenwu, of course, right now, I really think he's got to be changing his thought process. I have no idea what his aversion to Disruptors have been so far, but I really don't think he can continue forth without them. It's really interesting to see both go for stalkers right off the bat instead of adepts. This is just kind of that paranoia reigning in, but ultimately not a big deal. But going back to the point of disruptors for a moment, we're just seeing, again, Wellmo can fly away with upgrades, and he does in both of the first two games today. You know, in one game has like massive upgrades, second game kind of just decent upgrades. But none of that matters if you lose your army to disruptors. That's the beauty and the curse of disruptors. They either do such a good job that it looks ridiculous, or they do such a bad job they look like terrible units. And what I'm thinking is, like, maybe Wombazon had such a good experience with disruptors in the past and might be part of his aversion to them. Obviously can't say for certain, but regardless, the point still stands. If Wellmo doesn't do something different, if he can't get a timing that allows him to kill Drogo early on, the disruptors are always going to be killing him later in the game, every single time. But stalkers are oot and a boot, and with the pylon out at the front of the natural, there's no way that was going to get too much done. Looks like a probe did die on the other side. Mothership Corps will recall, barely getting out of there alive. Wellmo getting a decent scout with that too. Keep in mind, Drogo actually has not poked into his opponent's base yet, aside from the initial probe scout. And having seen two stalkers already show themselves on the other side of the map, I think he kind of has an idea how this opened. And while openings are certainly nice, you kind of go like, okay, check that off my list. We do the follow-up of a Stargate Commando Wellmo once again. I actually find this particularly interesting because not only is Drogo already displayed that he has anti-air and, of course, pylons and whatnot at home, he most importantly showed his couple of stalkers made right off the bat. There's going to be anti-air. So Wellmo to choose to do this after that fact is really interesting, and I'm not going to mark it up as foolish because there's a chance Drogo's out of position. There really is. But with a Mothership Corps, a couple of sentries at home, I really don't see this Oracle getting much damage done.
Okay, I figure out where we are.
Welcome
I got
back.
It. Nailed it.
The other point I was just going to make, sorry, real quick. Not only will it not get a lot of damage done, its use as a detector, revelation, all that good stuff is going to be a bit questionable. As we see, though, Wellmo does push with these stalkers, and it's exactly what I was talking about earlier on, where, like, if he can just get on top of Drogo early, he'll never have to worry about the disruptors in the first place. But force field's going down, and overcharge pops. These stalkers are getting low. Mothership Corps can probably get the last couple of hits on some of them, but with this being out of position, now that Oracle comes towards the main, but a couple stalkers are warped in, he's good on the defense, Mothership Corps goes down, and Drogo, yeah, he should be able to still take on these stalkers, 4-3.
Yeah, he still got it. I mean, that could have been worse. The stalkers could have pushed in maybe more aggressively, a passive with jump charge initially, that might have led to some things, or the Oracle could actually get a lot of damage done if he got to put those stalkers in the main. This still doesn't get, like, you know, game-ending damage, but 7 probes is certainly better than the 0 it was going to get.
Yeah, it's like game-evening up damage, and that just makes up for the difference of time with the natural more than anything else. There was another Oracle made, and he was even going for a third one. This actually takes away some of that killing power, but Mothership corresponds. Overcharge should be good. Oracle going to be driven off once again. Drogo, pretty good holds here, I gotta say, for what looked to be a terrible position.
It was tricky, you know, any lesser Protoss messes up on, like, both fronts, you know, and just straight up loses the game. But actually counterattacking is going to be interesting. I mean, there's
risky.
Just barely more for Drogo here, so that is risky. Zella gets warped in, so they would have to shoot them eventually.
Good
Oracle
focus
gets
fire.
Denied.
Yeah, really good focus fire on that Oracle. Second Oracle in the middle of the map, also a little bit out of position, snipes off an stalker and walks away. But all things considered, what I like most about this attack aren't about the actual things that died, it's not about the resources lost, it's the fact that one was advancing his tech beyond this. Like, he was actually going for a robot, he didn't just stick to a Stargate. It's hard to say the Stargate was really that effective this game. I mean, look at the worker count. Drogo had 9 workers killed, yet still sits on fairly close worker counts.
It should be worse for 9 workers, right? But it's actually only 3, so it's really not that bad. Wellmo is getting a warp prism and a void ray. Interesting to see the void ray. I know that Drogo also got a warp prism, but I guess it is like the initial defense against stalker warp prism, isn't it?
I mean, I like the idea of this being able to just float out and pick it off if it barely escapes and chills out here or down here type thing, but the void ray is such a freaking expensive unit. Like, you just cannot justify that cost in most situations, but to have 2? Like, he's really dedicating to this.
Yeah. He must be really scared of Drogo pushing in with a bunch of stalkers. Which is not, like, a false concern. There is a potential double attack if the War Prism wasn't caught off guard by the Void Ray, so One voider does its job. I don't know about the second one.
And, so, I just want to note, by the way, Drogo has continued saturating beyond his two bases right now. Wilmu did cut his probes pretty much right about where you need them to be. Mm-hmm. So I'm wondering if Drogo's looking towards the third, or if he just hit the P button a couple too many times. And yeah, Wilmu actually is going to be the one taking the third. Why is it the island base of all places? That's going to change things up just a little bit, I suppose. As Drogo does not have vision of this, he has traversed over the island a couple times and had even dropped stalkers there a few minutes ago. But as he takes a normal third and Wilmu takes a gold base, this is an interesting position, and this makes these void rays, I think, even more valuable now.
Yeah, like this makes, I guess, a little more sense now that he's trying to go for air. That way he can easily take care of probably anything that drops off from a war prism from Drogo and can actually go from his base to his other bases. But it's very difficult to get up to a nice enough count of void rays to really be like, oh, I'm definitely going to win now. Even though Void Ray Immortal is fantastic against Blink Stalkers, eventually Blink Stalkers will just rise in number usually. But the gold base might change that. I mean, the fact that he can actually secure a third base, because it is an island base, usually, you know, that's what's changing up the whole dynamic here. As if he was trying to take the normal one, Drogo probably denies it at least once or twice.
Well, that warp prism's going to accidentally find some awesome stuff to drop on. Overcharge is going to pop off. Little bit scary. There should be some wiggle room up here. Uh-oh. Warps in more stalkers. Now, this is an interesting problem to have. An island base fight's going to ensue. Reinforcement point now lost here for Drogo, and these void rays will go ham on this army.
Yeah. He's trying to run away, and he might just get him without the overcharge. Oh, maybe not.
He's focusing the probes with his dying breath. It's actually probably the best way to use the stalkers, to be honest, because these ults can be a little bit stranded for the time being. But this was a pretty big pickoff for Drogo, and I don't mean because he killed a lot of workers. In fact, he lost a lot of army doing that. But that's forcing Wilmu to push. Actually, hold the thought about what I was going to say for Drogo. Wilmu, if he pushes right now, there's no disruptors. He could probably actually take a really good fight.
That's what I was going to say. He sends Elucidated Phoenix in and actually says, no, I don't want to take this fight, which I think looking at that, he could. And certainly looking at the army supplies that we see, it looks like he could too. But maybe a little too scared of floating overcharges or just not entirely, you know, confident in his ward rays not getting sniped or something like that. Well, I don't know.
Drogo might be going for a base trade at this point. I don't know. Warp Prism goes directly to the main. His army now completely out of position. Force fields will lock him out of his own base, so his only option really is to base trade now.
He has an Archon to break the force field, but he's going through a choke anyway, so it's still not favorable. Drogo starts a Dark Shrine, maybe in anticipation of this base trade, and that's not a bad idea at all. There's only one observer for Wilmu.
It'll take a long time to finish up. And let's not forget the island base dynamic to this. Wilmu can not really be fully traded out.
Well,
Drogo would have to
go
to the island, and he can't.
Well, Drogo could eventually go to it with the warp prism.
Okay, I guess, but you bring like what, four stalkers against the Void Ray army like this size?
Oh yeah, you would have to like try and sneakily transfer all of your army with one warp prism. It would be difficult.
But... Actually, what happened to the Void Rays? Did they just die? Where'd they go? He lost like all the Void Rays.
To the overcharge. He must have just sent them into the overcharge.
Yeah, I was going to say, because these pylons are a little bit damaged, and that's what I realized as we come over. So that island base is no longer so impenetrable. Drogo may have just found an opportunity to actually take the game now. Stock is going to be brought over there on mobile. Production being compromised on both sides of this. That Dark Shrine might just finish, and this game just got a lot more interesting.
Yeah. I mean, I think it was pretty interesting with the base trade in general. I really wonder what would have happened trying to maneuver around said Void Rays, but it certainly made it a lot easier just getting the kills, because he didn't even have to sacrifice units to get those kills. The pylons took care of them.
And I just realized, too, there's no blink. That's why the maneuvering's been so awkward so far. Yeah. But you know what? Wilmu, does he have any observers? He's got one. So DTs won't be crazy bad, but DTs are still an option here for Drogo. He's a little supply blocked right now, so that sucks.
Drogo can't snipe that observer, so the DTs will never be like killing the army, but they can still help kill the buildings.
Drogo's still mining, and so is Wilmu, but they're both mining equally terrible just because nobody really has any probes.
Yeah, Drogo's on 16 on, you know, barely a base, and Wilmu's on 7 on a really good base, but he can't really use it.
Yeah, it's kind of awkward in that regard, but I do feel so much better because production kept alive for Drogo. Wilmu lost everything. In fact, the warp prism could shuffle maybe a probe back and power a couple of these buildings, but for the most part, Drogo, I think Drogo's got this. Double strike is starting up on the island. This, I'm sorry, Wamu. I like a gold base as much as the next person. I don't know that you can afford double stargates.
The gas will eventually be more of a problem than anything.
That's what I was thinking, yeah.
Well,
Stalker's gonna fall back. Yeah, it's so weird watching this happen with no blink. Just kind of maneuvering around. Gets a little bit off for that force field. Jogo's got to bring some of that army back or just go up to the main. Cancels the natural base. Probably a smart choice for the time being. Trading out not too poorly. Those immortals are always going to be better for the fight because, again, there's no blink. But, oh, where's the Mothership Core? She's got to be here for the overcharges. There we go.
There she is. Yeah, you can't push into this. I mean, already Drogo trading out his stalkers for all those adept.
Oh, he gets caught from the backside.
Yeah, he's
sandwiched into his own army, into his own base. Or his opponent's base, excuse me. Wellmu has only got a couple of immortals left, and that's not going to survive the overcharges, much less the adepts. Picks up those oh-so-precious stalkers, not even allowing them to die. And now Wellmu's stuck on two base, or one base, kind of two, but mostly one base here on the island.
Yeah.
And it's lost all over again.
So, that's what he does. Drogo, he actually spans twice.
Drogo, most importantly, only really needs Archons at this point. Like, Wellmu's not... Like, the cap of the amount of Void Rays you can make on one base is pretty severe. You're not... Like, even a fully mined out gold base, that's not going to make a maxed out army of Void Rays.
Yeah. Drogo has a couple of options. So he does double expand with all the minerals that he had, which I think is fine. I don't think you have to worry about Void Rays sniping your buildings quite yet.
Baited.
And by the time that they have enough Void Rays, the base will probably be mining, so...
I mean, Wellmu's doing a lot of really cool things right now that are still making this game a possibility for him. The drop of the Immortal, for example, over here. The War Prisms. He cleans up the Adepts with the Void Rays slowly, but he cleans them up. But the second Drogo gets back to a decent amount of mining, everything goes back in his favor, I feel.
Yeah. And there's the options come through. Like, Drogo can just go Mass Blink Stalker and, like, Mass Warp Prism or whatever and try and get on that base. Or Archon. Or he could try and go for his own Stargates. Like, his economy would eventually beat out Wemu's, like, you know, faster start. So.
Eventually, yeah. Look at the income graph, by the way, though. Wellmu is actually kicking ass with the gold base.
Gold base high? Yeah, it's definitely Drogo not having any minerals whatsoever that helps.
I was wondering what's going on. One DT brought over. There is an Observer here, however, so this is not going to quite get the kills he wants it to. Still get some kills.
Well, that was weird.
That looked really weird watching that. Yeah, the War Prism.
He will always get some kills, unless, like...
The Archon can't reach the front line because the other Archon merging in was blocking it.
Well, amazing.
This is so silly. I mean, Wellmu... I give him big ups, big credits. Love what he's done. I just don't know that it's going to be enough. The funny thing is, though, Drogo, as we can see, is actually struggling to fight these Void Rays because he doesn't really have a big army.
That's what I'm worried about, actually, is that Drogo is, like, you know, fine and dandy mining finally, but he has, like, it's like 2-3 minutes where his army's still not going to be as good against Void Rays specifically. I guess it's where floats and overcharges are really going to be very important to make sure that Wemo does not hit this time where his army is actually better. But it is a little worrying.
Well, with more Archons finally being... I mean, there's like one Archon at a time before is what was taking away a lot of this. And as the Void Rays starts stacking up, that splash damage becomes more valuable. But and I don't know if he wants to go over hallucinations or what the deal is. This is still very harrowing. But as we see, the Void Rays trying to use their range advantage as the Archons can't quite reach them.
Yeah, Archon's not down that quick with Void Rays.
What's Archon range? 3, Void range is 6. So yeah, they can definitely outrange them.
More structures going down. They're not super important right now.
Oh,
but
hello.
To get some free adepts to stop them from scouting, of course, his warpers might scout it, is pretty big. So it's worth trying to kill those adepts, especially if you get all of them. I mean, that'd be pretty good.
Yeah, and it looks like you get a lot of them for free. But Drogo doesn't actually see that Nexus coming down. This is how Wellmu really actually starts getting back into this.
Adept action.
Yeah, it's rallied over. Okay.
Really like that Drogo's bothering to do this. He knows a warp prism was out. He saw it every single time there was a fight. So he knows that a secret base could have been attempted.
Yeah, he's going to try and defend this with the Void Rays, but this is not a problem, because if Wellmu would take it as natural, or his other third, right? This is something where the Void Rays are close enough to defend, but this is so far away. There's just no way. He better cancel this. There's no way.
He's going to try and save it? Okay, yeah.
Oh my god, that Warp Prism died so fast.
Yeah, he tried to warp in a stalker to kill Wellmu's Warp Prism. Not going to happen. Drogo finally getting Blink as well, so whenever the Void Rays over-dedicate, he can actually pounce upon them.
Or just Blink away. if he gets caught out of position.
Away. Yeah, if he's actually in a bind. Another base trying to be taken, and I mean, it maybe Drogo does eventually lose the Adepts. And if he ever loses the Adepts, maybe he never feels confident enough pushing out with his main army. But the Adepts would have had to have died by, like, now, I think. Once again, just scouting going down everywhere once they know we're almost taking that base. And Drogo's main army is getting big enough to start splitting up and still be fine against Void Rays. But one was going to go for Tempests.
So he's also going to melt a base.
Yeah.
Holy moly.
Oh,
no, he doesn't quite get it.
To go for it. Okay. He was really scared of the Foot Over Charges or the Blink Stalkers be there.
He maybe could have left like one Void Ray on that and finishing off. I don't know. Establishing his base in the south, though, a lot of this pressure that he's doing is important because it means that Drogo can't so willy-nilly go scouting around the map once again. Even though he spread out all his Adepts, he actually did not see the new base. You know, they're sprinkled everywhere down here, and he's missed it once again.
Okay, he's checking. He's like, wait a minute.
There we go.
Well, Womo has enough to warp in maybe an Adept to counter the one Adept, but Drogo can, of course, collapse in on it. And his mining is up to that point where it's just like, okay, he's obviously going to win because he's on about to be three bases mining.
So
his production's going to be way, way better. Even if Womo has a Mothership core, or a Mothership, rather, and Tempests.
Did you see that pickup drop from my girl?
It was amazing.
That actually wasn't too bad. But you're right, like, the Mothership itself, I thought for certain it would be Tempest over this, right? You use that range advantage to just kind of hang over this cliff and never have anything touch you, but what I'm so concerned about is Drogo has never made any indication of trying to go any other direction in this game. I think he wants to starve Welmu out, have Welmu attack into him, hope his Archons and Stalkers are just overall better, but that Mothership really shakes things up.
I believe that was the War Prison.
That was the War Prism going down in the north. Womo had two. Is that both of them gone now? No, he's still got one more. Okay. Just brought the probes back home. He's going to mine out in a moment, though. But this is what we talked about before. Like, there's just not enough minerals simply on this base to max out an army. I mean, 62 army supply while in the sky, that's not going to be enough, I'm afraid.
Yeah, he has to start just mining.
Oh, especially if he gets picked off like this. He misclicked one of his own stalkers.
And Drogo doesn't have his own observer, but
he
does have a
He just
robo.
Had it. It just flew away, didn't he? No, you're right. He doesn't even have one. My bad. Thought I saw one. Oh, great. This is devastating. He's running away because he has to.
He's going
to
get an observer, though. Like, he might lose this Nexus, but this is actually his least important Nexus right now. He's got two other full mining bases, and he can also just target the Mothership. No more cloaking.
Oh my god, she gets away with 22 health. Hypothetical, though, yeah, he leaves the Void Rays out of position, so they're decloaked as well. GG goes, and Drogo will finally lock down what is a 3-0 start to the Ting wildcard group.
Huh.
That game was about a gajillion times crazier than I thought it would be, though.
It lasted certainly a lot longer.
All right, so Wilma will have the losers manage to perhaps recover, and Drogo goes on to the winners. We are going to go to a break, though, and talk specifically from our sponsors while we go find our next match on North America, where it is going to be Solar versus Sort of. ZVZ. So guaranteed ZVP's following it up, which is kind of interesting. But here's a word from Ting, guys. Kicking off our day. We'll see you in a few moments.